How do you fix this? Abandoned homes, foreclosures weighing down neighborhoods. It's America's continuing foreclosure crisis, and it's playing out in cities just like this one, Orange, New Jersey. Architects here at the Museum of Modern Art think they might have the solution, and believe it or not, it involves building in the streets.
This is an experiment to look at what happens if you get rid of streets, and we create a pedestrian city.
The plan by architects Hilary Sample and Michael Meredith is on display in an exhibit called Foreclosed, Rehousing the American Dream.
We're not necessarily saying it's going to fix everything, but the idea that it provokes a kind of new discussion and conversation.
Their idea, fill the streets with housing and office space, make it pedestrian friendly, and eliminate the tax burden of upkeep on the roads. Looking at life after the foreclosure crisis, the exhibit reimagines how we live.
It's not sufficient to fix subprime, globalize who holds the debt, and go back to building McMansions that take us 3 hours to drive to.
There really is no such thing as a typical American suburb. But this phenomenon expresses itself, it manifests itself quite differently in different parts of the country.
Curators Barry Bergdahl and Reinhold Martin challenged architects to reimagine five suburbs across the country.
All of them lie within metropolitan areas that are growing. There's opportunities in these decaying suburbs.
For example, picture Kaiser, Oregon as a city powered by its own methane dome.
It's creative, but how is it a solution to foreclosures?
The show, I should say, in general, is not trying to solve the mortgage crisis. That's for the banks to sort out. We're saying, since we also have learned from it, that the way we build is part and parcel of this massive foreclosure crisis.
We took the plans out to Orange in Essex County, which has one of the state's highest foreclosure rates.
No, I really like it.
Fantastic.
Sounds like something from the Jetsons.
It's hard to imagine that we can solve all of the problems of Orange. I mean, the biggest problem we have to deal with is this constant sprawl and expansion.
Orange Mayor Eldridge Hawkins had not yet seen the plans.
Could it help solve the crisis?
I think it's a novel idea. I think it might be a little bit more futuristic, something down the road. But the theme in and of itself is not that strange or different from what we're trying to establish here.
He and planning director Valerie Jackson have made strides trying to turn Orange around.
Our strategy as it relates to foreclosed and vacant properties is a block-by-block approach.
Where we're standing now, we used to have housing projects. We successfully demolished that entire site and have now erected 2- and 3-story townhomes.
So will buildings in the streets be next?
Maybe in the future, but I will say, directly answer your question, the entire city of Orange will not be a carless community.
Poppy Harlow, CNN Money, reporting.